Hello viewers, today we are starting the science syllabus. As you know well that the branches of science are physics, chemistry and biology. Let we learn about the first chapter of the biology of class 9, tissue. Definition of tissue. Tissue is group of cells similar in structure and function. The types of plant tissue. Plant tissues are divided into two types, permanent tissue and meristematic tissue. Permanent tissue are again divided into two types, simple permanent tissue, complex permanent tissue. A simple permanent tissue is one which having only one type of cell. That's why it is called simple permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissue again divided into three types, parenchyma, colenchyma, and sclerenchyma. Complex permanent tissue are those tissue which contain more than one type of cell. There are two types of complex permanent tissue, xylem and phloem. Let me know about the details of the tissues one by one. First is meristematic tissue. The characteristic of a meristematic tissue. Cells are immature, very active and have capacity to divide. The cells have dense cytoplasm with thin cellulose wall and there is no vacuole present in that. So they are present at the growing region. So depending upon the region they are present, they are divided into three types. Apical meristem, which is present at the tip of the root and the shoot, which increase the length of the root and the shoot. Then intercalary meristem present at the base of the leaf or the internode, and the lateral meristem is present laterally, which increase the thickness of the root and the shoot. So overall, the meristematic tissue help in the growth of the plant. Now coming to the permanent tissue. In this, first is simple permanent tissue. So there are types are there. First type is parenchyma. Generally, the cell of the parenchyma, they are round with thin wall of cellulose. It is a living tissue because it having the protoplasm, and it present in all soft part of the plant. Presence of the large vacuole and many intercellular spaces are present in this tissue. It support the plant and also store the food. A parenchyma which containing the chlorophyll is called as the chlorenchyma, which involved in the photosynthesis is present in the leaf. The one type of the parenchyma is the aerenchyma, which having the air filled space, which is present in the aquatic plant, which help in the buoyancy. Buoyancy, that is the ability to float the plant on the surface of the water. Then the second type is the colenchyma. The characteristic of the colenchyma, it is a living tissue. Cells are elongated and irregularly thickened by cutting. Very little intercellular space is present. It give mechanical support to the plant. It is present in leaf, stalk, below the epidermis. So this about the colenchyma. Then third type of simple permanent tissue is sclerenchyma. The characteristic of sclerenchyma, it is a dead tissue because it loses the protoplasm. The cells are long, narrow, and wall is very thick, made up of lignin. No intercellular spaces are present. It is present in stem, vein, leaves, and in the hard covering of seed and nuts. So this is about the sclerenchyma. Now coming to the complex permanent tissue. A complex permanent tissue is the tissue which contains more than one type of cells. First type is xylem. Xylem is water conducting tissue. Xylem made up of four components: tracheid, vessel, xylem fiber, and xylem parenchyma. Trachea, vessel, xylem fiber, they are the dead component. And xylem parenchyma is the living component. Trachea and vessels, they are the very elongated cells placed one to end and very thick and lignified cell wall. So they help in the conducting of the water in plant. Now the second type of the complex permanent tissue is phloem. It is a food conducting tissue. The component of the phloem are, there are four components: tube, companion cell, phloem parenchyma and phloem fiber. Tube, companion cell, phloem parenchyma, these are the living components, and phloem fiber is the dead component. Tube, they are the very elongated tube-like cells placed end to end. The adjacent of the tube, the wall present adjacent to the tube, it is perforated, that is called as the tube plate. So the food particles, they move from one tube to other by the tube plate. Adjacent to the tube is present the lens-shaped cells. They are called companion cells. So these companion cells controlling the food conduction, and the food tube help in the conducting of the food. And to this companion cell, presence of the phloem parenchyma and phloem fiber. Phloem fiber help to support the plant. So this is about the phloem. It is a food conducting tissue. This is about the all the types of the plant tissue. Hope you have understand. Thank you.